Welcome to our 19th video on word roots illustrated. In this video, we are going to cover the Latin and Greek roots starting with AC, all of which lend the meaning sharp or tip or bitter to various interesting words in English, which can be learnt effectively using this root connection. So let's begin. Our initial four words contain the Greek root akron, which means tip or summit. That is, the highest point of a hill or mountain. Acrobat is one of the most common words based on this root. Made up of roots acro, meaning tip, and banin, meaning to walk, the word acrobat literally referred to someone who walks on tiptoe, such as a tightrope walker. Nowadays, acrobat popularly stands for any entertainer who performs spectacular gymnastic feats. Next is acrophobia. Now, since acro means summit or tip and phobia means fear, acrophobia means an extreme or abnormal fear of heights, especially when one is not particularly high up. It is a pathological condition wherein one experiences falling sensations and symptoms such as breathlessness and loss of thinking ability when they are at a height. Next word is acropolis. Again, acro means summit or top of a hill and polis means city. So acropolis literally means a city on top of a hill. The word acropolis originally referred to the ancient citadel at Athens containing the Parthenon and other notable buildings, mostly dating from the 5th century BC. Nowadays, the word acropolis can mean the upper fortified part of any ancient Greek city such as Athens or even any other city or district elsewhere as in Central America. Now, one of the most interesting words based on this root is acronym. Acronym is formed out of tip and name and is basically formed when you pick the tip or the first letters of each word that comprise a long name. With an expression as simple as "Oh my God," the acronym for which is OMG, to names of telephone services such as SMS, which stands for short messaging service, to the name of international organizations such as IMF, which stands for International Monetary Fund, and corporations such as KFC for Kentucky Fried Chicken, and HP, and even names of processes such as B2B and names of diseases such as AIDS. You will find acronyms everywhere. That is to say, they are all pervasive. Check out the acronyms in the following sentence. A company such as HP, which is an acronym of Hewlett Packard, engages in B2B, an acronym for business-to-business marketing, to sell its products such as printers. With a slight variation of the word root, any word that starts with AC or ACU will have the meaning of sharp, like the tip of something. For instance, we have the word acme, which is very common in English and means the tip or peak of a mountain. The word figuratively stands for the highest level of something, the point at which something is at its best or most highly developed. An example sentence would be, he was at the acme of his sporting career when the unfortunate accident happened and he lost his leg. Similarly, we have the word acupuncture. Acu means sharp, as needle is, and acupuncture literally means to puncture with a needle. The word stands for a system of complementary medicine in which fine needles are inserted in the skin at specific points along what are considered to be lines of energy, used in the treatment of various physical and mental conditions. Another important word based on the root acu is acute. Something that is acute is sharp, keen, or severe. The word is generally used for an unpleasant or unwelcome situation or phenomenon present or experienced to a severe or intense degree. For instance, in summer months, the desert areas face an acute scarcity of water and the inhabitants of such regions have to walk for miles to arrange potable water. Though the word could also be used for a sharp insight or perception. For instance, Those in the new age industries such as IT should have an acute awareness of changing trends in order to have a viable career. Next word is acuity. If you are talking about the sharpness or keenness of thought, vision or hearing, the appropriate word to use would be acuity. Similarly, if we use the word acumen, we are talking about the sharpness of judgment and the ability to make good decisions. An example sentence for usage of both words would be, at work, people marveled at his intellectual acuity as he could remember even the most intricate details and envied his business acumen, because of which the company had grown leaps and bounds under his leadership. Again, let's introduce a change in the word stem to ACR. The meaning of this root is also sharp, but in the sense of harsh and bitter. One of the most common words starting with this prefix is acrid. The word is generally used for a taste or smell that is very sharp, pungent or harsh, like acid. For instance, while the building caught fire and burned down in no time, the acrid smell of smoke lingered on for hours. Acrid can also be used more broadly to describe something that is offensive in a similar way. You can say that someone who is very harsh on others has an acrid personality, and even a comment that stung like acid could be called acrid. A similar word is acerbic, which means bitter, sour or severe, though in a different context. Acerbic could be used for someone's style of speaking or writing that is sharp and forthright and literally tastes sour or bitter. In English, there is another word, acerb, which is practically synonymous with acerbic in this sense. That is, tasting sour or bitter, though the word acerbic is less commonly used in this meaning nowadays. Coming to the main meaning, consider a boss making the following statement for his subordinate. I could very well pay a donkey and extract a better work out of it. Such a statement is very acerbic, and the obvious reaction from the employee was that he was disheartened when his hard work got so cruelly dismissed by his boss. And while bitterness of taste is aptly described by acerb, a bitterness of feelings is described by the adjective acrimonious. Acrimonious means full of spite or ill feeling, bitter, nasty, and is generally used to describe something like a speech or an argument. The related noun is acrimony. An example sentence would be, the divorce settlement meeting ended with acrimony on both sides. During the meeting, the estranged couple argued acrimoniously about the child custody and the division of property. The next word derived from this root acer is exacerbate, made up of the prefix ex, which in one of its meanings expresses inducement of a state, and acerbus, meaning harsh or bitter. The word literally means made harsh. To put it in a simpler way, if something is already bad and it becomes worse, we use the word exacerbate. The word exacerbate means to make a problem or a bad situation or even a negative feeling worse. For example, exposure to pollens exacerbated her allergy and induced continuous sneezing. So much for the word stem AC. And now on an ending note, we have the word root oxy, which shares the same meaning of sharp with the previous roots. And while we have the common words like oxygen, which are based on this root, one word that I think every English lover should know is oxymoron. Well, oxy means sharp and moron means foolish. So oxymoron literally means sharp as well as foolish. Contradictory, isn't it? So oxymoron is a figure of speech in which we use contradictory words together. And you must have figured out by now that the word oxymoron itself is an oxymoron. Some common oxymorons that deserve a mention here. Her life was an open secret. He was clearly confused. Those children were found missing after school. She obtained an original copy of that branded purse from a flea market. A seasoned actor acts naturally. There was a deafening silence in that room. Now, my take on oxymorons is that they are seriously funny. And our last word is paroxysm. Literal meaning is beyond sharpened or goad. And if one gets goaded or irritated too much, one can expect a sudden outburst, which is what this word means. In medical terminology, paroxysm stands for a sudden attack or increase of symptoms of a disease, such as pain, coughing, shaking, etc., that often occurs again and again. But in a broader sense, the word paroxysm could be used for any sudden attack or outburst of a particular emotion or activity, such as paroxysm of rage, or for example, this sentence. The joke was so hilarious that he burst into a paroxysm of laughter. Now test your understanding of the words learnt in this lesson by filling in the blanks below. It is recommended that you pause the video when the timer starts. That brings us to the end of this video. Hope you liked it. Subscribe our channel and stay tuned for more such videos. Thank you.